So I would like to start this off by talking about Trump's taxes. This is an article from The Hill. Tax records show 200 entities funneled money to Trump properties while reaping benefits from the White House, the New York Times reports. I like The Hill as far as like news, just because their front end is so good. You know, you don't have a bunch of pop-up advertisements. You don't got the autoplay videos. I appreciate that. So, I read from The Hill just because it's basic. It's good on-screen content, right? A New York Times analysis of tax records showed more than 200 companies, special interest groups, and foreign governments have funneled millions of dollars to Trump's properties while reaping benefits from the president and his administration. Now, this is stuff that we have known for years. Now, it's different knowing that, oh, that's weird. Why is the Saudi Arabian crown prince and all of his like guards or whatever, why are they all spending millions of dollars at the Trump Hotel in Washington, D.C., right? Isn't that a little strange, right? We've known this for years, but it's a whole different story when you finally have the actual tax records and you're able to actually trace the sheer volume of times that this has happened, right? It's just bizarre. Nearly a quarter. I love that little language there. That's really, really good. But nearly a quarter of entities have not been previously reported. 60 patrons who promoted specific interests to the Trump administration spent almost $12 million on expenses associated with the Trump organization during the first 2 years of Trump's presidency. The Times reported nearly all of these customers saw their interests move forward. Now, this is another thing that's super basic, and that's what's like unfortunate about this is like every president has done this kind of stuff, but not many, if any, presidents, at least in modern times, maybe since Nixon, have been so brazen about their corruption. You know, Trump just waves it in your face. Like, he just pulls his pants down and shoves his ass in your face all the time. And yet, you still have Trump supporters that are like, he's draining the swamp. He's draining the swamp. He's fighting for the little guy. He's fighting for the little guy. And it's like, dude, these people are like, I really just, at this point in time, you have to, right, have no information at your disposal whatsoever. If you are a Trump supporter, either that or you're just a blatant fascist. And there's tons of people, especially like the people in like YouTube chat rooms and stuff that love, "Ooh, I'm gonna troll gay people online for fucking 8 hours a day. That's gonna be my job. I get home from work and I start up my second job of trolling gay people on the internet, of trolling black people on the internet. I'm gonna troll some transgender people online, and that's gonna be what I'm gonna dedicate my life to, because these people are fucking cringe." But there's that other subset of people that just don't pay attention to the news, and they somehow still think Donald Trump is draining the swamp. It's bizarre. It really is bizarre. Like, I really just like. You could write thousands and thousands of books on just like what has to go wrong in a society over the course of a couple centuries in order to produce people like Donald Trump supporters. And again, I'm not really talking about the outright fascists, right? The outright fascists, like fascists, they're garbage, they're scum of the earth, they're terrible, but at least like they have some sort of coherent thought process. At least like their whole goal is to kill minorities and like have like a giant like fucking homeland for white people or something, right? At least they've got an outline, they've got some sort of strategy, but like the small government weirdos that are on the Trump train, I really just it's bizarre to me. In interviews with I think actually 60 patrons, no, with interviews with almost 250 business executives, club members, lobbyists, Trump property employees, and current administration officials, sources detailed to the Times how Trump conducted business and interacted with customers who were seeking help from the administration. The Trump organization's customers included foreign politicians, Florida barons, what is that even? What does that even mean? A Chinese billionaire, a Serbian prince, clean energy advocates. I love clean energy. The best energy, clean energy. What was it that he said? It was a clean coal, clean coal. I love it. I love getting some clean coal all over my skin and my lungs. Petroleum industry leaders, small government advocates, and contractors. The newspaper noted that some of the president's customers did not see their interests fully fulfilled, but noted whether they won or lost, Mr. Trump benefited financially. And that's another thing that's important here, is that even if you don't want to do anything afterward, after you get paid, guess what? You're the president. What are they going to do? Start a war against you? Try to put a hit out on you? Okay, let's see how that goes, right? More than 70 advocacy groups, businesses, and foreign governments held events at Trump Organization properties that previously were at different locations or developed new events to be hosted at the properties. Religious organizations also participated by throwing prayer meetings, banquets, and tours on Trump properties. At least 24 patrons who reserved events for 2017 and 18 at Trump properties had interests involving the administration. The analysis also found that more than 100 companies that sought action from the federal government spent money at Trump properties. This is, I think, this part is going to be really important. Being a member of his clubs also allowed leaders to get time with the president and sometimes his support, as he offered ambassadorships to 5 members and chose others for advisory roles in his administration. Now, do you remember the impeachment circus, the fake news media, big Democrat hoax, right, where he was impeached? And one of the key players, what was his name? He was the ambassador to the EU. But he was like a big Trump donor, and he just became ambassador. Gordon Sondland, correct. I think that was the guy's name, Gordon Sondland, who is a big-time donor, and all of a sudden, you donate bunches of money. All of a sudden, you're caught in the middle of the impeachment hoax, right? Isn't that really interesting? That you can go from giving someone money to being the ambassador to the European Union really makes you think. Really makes you think. White House spokesperson Judd Deere told The Hill in a statement that the Times report was just more fake news. This is yet another politically motivated hit piece, inaccurately smearing a standard business deal. A standard business deal, interesting, he said. During his years as a successful businessman, Donald Trump was longtime partners with Phil Ruffin and earned whatever payments he received. This is the same 2016 playbook that the American people rejected resoundingly. Rejected resoundingly, what? He got less votes. Like whatever. Like, yes, he was elected president, blah, blah, blah. But if you're going to say the American people rejected Trump, how can you say that? The guy got less votes. He lost the election. He got less votes. Yes, that is my favorite. When people reject something by voting in favor of it, right? Like, what? Like, they're rejecting the fake news media and the Democrat hoax by voting more for Democrats? What? Doesn't make any sense. Deere told the Times in a statement that the president turned over the day-to-day responsibilities of the Trump Organization to his 2 adult sons. That doesn't mean that he can't benefit from it. Like, that's the thing, that, like, they really think that Trump people are stupid. And they are. They're dumb as hell. They actually buy this. They go like, oh, yeah, Trump gave over his properties to his sons, right? And it's, you know, after the election or after, you know, the presidency, he's totally not going to gain anything from that. No. It's not like he dissolved all of his companies or anything. No, right? It's not like his sons are just going to pay him back or give him the ownership roles back after the presidency, and he's going to retain all of the benefits of people spending money at his properties over the course of his presidency. No. No, his sons are controlling the Trump Organization. It's his sons, right? Because it's all fake news. It's all fake news. But again, these people live in an alternate reality. They live in a different universe, right? And this is something that's been brewing for the last few decades, but it's like reaching a boiling point here, where you have people that literally live in different fucking universes, right? And again, I'm not talking about the fascists who just want to kill transgender people, black people, and Jewish people. They're just cringe, right? They've got a worldview that's at least somewhat consistent, and that's the difference here, but they're just terrible people. But I'm saying, like, how are these small government conservatives falling for this? How are, like, the libertarian Republicans, and not all of them are voting for Joe Jorgensen, how are they falling for this? I really, like, the mental gymnastics politics that need to go on to say, I love America, and also Donald Trump is a great president. The way that you believe both of those things at once or whatever is just astounding. And this is something we should all, like there's going to be research done, just in the way that there was a lot of research done on how the hell did Adolf Hitler take control of Nazi Germany, right? Like, how did that happen, right? There's been a lot of research, and all of that research apparently has been thrown out the window because it's happening again in the United States of America. But my point is, over the next couple of decades, we're going to probably be looking back on this era, whether it ends, you know, in a couple weeks, or if it ends in 4 years from now, or if it ends in 12 years from now. God knows what's going to happen. But when this era ends, and assuming it doesn't end in nuclear fallout, we're going to have to do a lot of retrospection on what the hell is going on with white people, because seriously, man, these fuckers, they're nuts. Like, and Donald Trump profiting off of his presidency, like, no shit. No shit. Anyone who thought that he was going to do otherwise, I'm sorry. You got bamboozled. You got had. You got took. It's okay. It happens to the best of us. But what's important is that we learn from our mistakes. Are you really going to support this guy again? And I'm not telling you to vote for Biden. Vote third party. Vote for Joe Jorgensen. Vote for Howie Hawkins. Write in Harambe again, because that worked so well last time. Just why would you vote for Donald Trump? Do you really hate your friends and family and your country that much? Are you that much of a dullard? Like, again, I get why the people who want to kill transgender people would vote for Trump. That's at least in congruence with their ideology. But if your ideology is, like, balancing the budget, what? If your ideology is American pride, what? We're the laughingstock of the world. If your ideology is, like, you know, if you're apolitical and you just want to see a comedian in the White House, I mean, you can watch his podcast that he's inevitably going to do on OAN in a couple years from now. Like, again, like, it's just bizarre to me that people are willing to destroy the planet just for internet memes. It's weird. But again, Trump corrupt? Who'da thunk? Right? Who'da thunk?